Well, our weather right now is about as far as we can get from winter. It's hot. Today it happens to be raining, so we're inside, unfortunately, on this dog day of summer.
Yes, but it is a hot day out there. At least this weekend's looking very, very hot. So it's important to keep cool in these hot days. Here with us, some projects that you and your grandkids can do outside in the shade is Liz Heinecke. She is the author of several books, including Outdoor Science Lab for Kids. Hi, Liz. Welcome back.
Hi. How are you?
Good. How are you? Good to see you again.
Yeah, it's good to be here. I'm excited to share some experiments that kids can do outside, you know, in the shade, in the driveway.
I love it.
And it gets them out into nature, but also out exploring some science.
Because a lot of times when it's really, really hot, they want to sit inside on the TV, on the screens, and every parent is like, get outside and
do something.
Yeah. So I love
these ideas. These are projects that are fun enough the kids will want to get out and do them.
Good.
So,
all right.
Okay, we're going to start with, this is called like plant pounding. So kids can go out, you know, the gardens are just, everything's blooming this
year.
We've had so much rain, there are flowers everywhere. So if kids go out and collect things like leaves and flowers from tomato plants, they can learn a little bit about plant cells and about symmetry. So basically have them collect some flowers, you know, obviously get permission if it's a fancy garden. And then they can put the flowers on a piece of like old linen or napkin, put it face up, fold it over. And we're gonna try this. It works better on concrete like driveways.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then I'm gonna give each of you one of these mallets. You can do it with a hammer too. Go ahead and pound it kind of right where the flower is. Okay, that's good.
No, we need more.
Yeah, it's hard to do on this table. Okay, let's see how yours looks. Okay, open it up. Okay, now we'll peel this off. Isn't that beautiful?
Oh, wow, no kidding.
Yeah, so I did it with some tomato leaves over here. And when you peel, the other thing that's cool is kids can see that they make a symmetric image, right? And they're really pretty. You can do this with like you could do a tablecloth. If you had a bunch of kids, you could do a tablecloth for a birthday party. It's crafty, but they're also seeing how when they burst plant cells, the pigment, and pigment is a word for the molecules that give things color, right? The pigment go ahead, comes off onto the cloth.
This is a marigold. See? It's a much bigger flower.
Marigolds will look a little mushy, but you get some nice color, right?
Just pick that off,
Isn't that pretty?
Well, and the smells too.
Oh, yeah.
I did. I went to town.
That is really cool.
Yeah.
I like that.
So that gets kids out
into nature. Well, that marigold has a smell.
Yeah. And you could do it like you brought basil.
I brought basil. You can do herbs.
The smell too.
Oh, that's what I smell.
Oh, that's a good idea. Yeah. They can also close their eyes and try to identify, you know, different herbs. So, yeah.
Look at that.
Let them be creative.
Perfect.
Cool.
Okay. This is super easy and I love it because all you need is construction paper. And the cheaper the paper, the better. So you just go out, have kids once again collect leaves. They can use stencils. And I actually use sunscreen on this one. They put the objects on the paper. They cover it with plastic wrap, weigh it down with rocks, and put it out in the sun. And what happens is the sun's UV rays damages the paper, bleaches the paper out, and where it's protected, can you see this? Where it's protected by the leaves, when you take it off, and this is just from a few hours in the sun, it protects the color. This is cool, right?
Yeah, that's
so they can see, oh, the sun damages the paper. So this, if you take paper, you put plastic over it, have them paint some sunscreen on it.
Yeah, make a message.
Yep, leave it out in the sun. You take it off, and look how sunscreen protects the paper.
What a great lesson in the values of sunscreen.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
You can say the sun can damage your skin the way it damages the paper.
So I like that the cheaper paper's better, right?
Cheaper the better, Everyone has construction paper around if they have
and
kids.
And saran wrap,
Saran wrap, super
Perfect.
Easy, fun. I've run over several of these in the driveway, so be sure to move them from behind the car before you back up.
It happens.
Yeah. Okay.
Next up, balloons.
Every kid will love this. I'm giving you each a pair of goggles.
Okay.
Kids can just wear sunglasses, but we obviously were supposed to be outside today, and we can't be.
Yeah.
But you can focus the sun's energy. If you stand with the sun behind you, magnifying glass is a lens that will focus the sun's energy to a single spot on the balloon, right? So kids can do this. In a few seconds, and I'm going to demonstrate with the lighter.
Yeah.
Imagine this is the sun's energy all focused on one spot on the balloon. In a few seconds, their balloon will pop, and kids think it's awesome.
You know, that whole magnifying glass thing, I tried it as a youth. I never really had much luck. So.
Really?
With the balloon? You tried this
Not
experiment?
A balloon, just like...
Oh, to like burn stuff?
Other things.
Yeah. Balloon is easy because it's really thin rubber. It heats up really quickly in one spot, and it pops. So it's very satisfying, you know. Okay.
I would never think to do that, but I do like that. I use my magnifying glass.
And kids, if they want to, they can like fill the balloon up with confetti before they do it, so when it explodes.
Oh, that's super fun. Yeah. You can keep them entertained for hours with just that.
And now
you have water. I'm going to try not to get the studio too wet. This is a fun project kids can do to learn about centripetal force. Yep. It's not centrifugal force, like a lot of people say. It's centripetal force. So when you have an object on the end of a string or like this bucket, and you're swinging it in a circle, the object, what's in the bucket, wants to fly off in all directions, right? You can imagine, like, if your hair is wet and you go like this, the water goes like this. If something is stopping it, like this bucket, you can actually spin it and the water won't fall out. So I'm going to take this bucket. See, there's a bunch of water in it.
Yep.
All right, let's see. I'm swinging it around. So I'm swinging it over my head and no water's coming out, right?
I'm confirming to everybody at home there is water in there.
Okay, yeah.
It's filled up to like here with water.
Yes, and I made this last night. This is a fun thing kids can make. You can do the same thing with a glass of water. I just took a Tupperware lid. I used a nail to make some holes in it, put some ropes in it, so it's like a little platform.
A little swing.
Okay, we'll see if this works.
No.
Putting a glass, you can see the water in this glass, right?
Did you try this one at home first?
I don't know. Okay, ready? Let's see.
Whoa!
Oh, wow.
Okay. And then you have to kind of stop it slowly, but look.
Wow.
Isn't that cool?
That is impressive.
Yeah, so you kids can do this outside, but it's a fun way for them to play with water. And, of course, eventually they'll probably throw the water on each other. But it's all good,
right? Then it turns into water balloon fights.
Yeah, the dogs have the cooling vests. We have water balloons, right, and buckets of water.
I love it. You have so many great tips in here for parents, too. Inside, outside, all kinds of fun things. We did the giant bubbles last
time. Oh, the giant bubbles are so much fun, yeah.
That's a good one.
Water rockets are fun. Another one you can't really do in the studio.
Yeah.
But yeah, there's so much. The driveway is a great place to do science. You know, they can make goo with like a cup of cornstarch, half a cup of water makes that amazing oobleck. But if you have it in the driveway, they can just hose it off.
Yeah,
you know?
Right. No
they can also spread it out on the driveway and paint on it with watercolors.
And
there are all kinds of, get them outside.
So
just
smart.
Saying.
I love it, Liz. Thank you.
Thank you.
Super fun. We'll post a link if you would like to purchase Outdoor Science Lab for Kids at MinnesotaLive.com.